You don't want to look at the camera.
Yeah. Yours, mine, ours. I could do this.
This is Yuki now. He's 1 year old. He's cute. He needs to be groomed. He's supposed to be going to the groomers tomorrow. He's really clingy. He has a lot of personality. I'm a little chilly, so I'm about to put on this sweater. Welcome back to my channel. It's Kayla. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing 5 things I wish I knew before buying a dog. I'm just going to be sharing with you guys what my experience has been like becoming a dog owner, because I've always been a cat person. This is why I wanted a camera in the first place, because I can use my phone and look at my talking points while I'm talking to you. And I can actually look at you and you can look back at me, and I'm not figuring out where to look. But so much has happened and I have so much to share with you guys, and I have so much to give. I just cannot wait to push out content. Like, I'm so excited. That was a long intro, but let's get right into it. Then make sure you subscribe to my channel. So the first thing that I wish that I knew before I bought a dog was that puppies shouldn't walk on pavement too often when it's hot outside. Some people, like, that's a no-brainer. I told y'all I was a cat owner. Like, I have helped my brother and my sister raise like 2 or 3 litters of cats, so I knew everything that I possibly know about cats. And even though I did my research about dogs, this is just something that I just I should have knew, but I didn't know. Because one time I was out walking Yuki, pretty hot outside, but I wasn't even thinking about how hot the concrete probably felt on his paw pads, and I was wondering why he wasn't really walking. Like, he didn't really want to walk, and this was when he was like 10 or maybe 12 weeks old. I really feel like I should have waited to start walking, but we'll talk about that later on in the video. This little boy stopped me because I was wondering why he wasn't walking, and I was like, come on Yuki, you know, come on Yuki. Like, you know, they were riding their bikes and playing, and they stopped, and like, oh, you know, I think that your dog's not walking, doesn't really want to walk because the pavement probably feels too hot for his paws. Instantaneously, I was like, yo, I feel so bad. How did that not register? How did I not know that? I felt so dumb. I felt so bad because I'm like, dang, like, I'm wondering why he's over here, like, not wanting to walk, and he's over here struggling. His paws probably hurt. So instantly, like, I took him inside, and like, that was that. I took him out on cooler days. Number 2, taking care of a dog is like taking care of a child. Now, recently, if you haven't visited my channel before, I am a young mom. I had a baby last year. I'm 21 now, but I got pregnant at 19. Similarly, especially like looking back at it now, like, taking care of a puppy is literally like taking care of a human child. Like, I tell you, when I first brought him home, he didn't want to sleep in his crate. He wanted to sleep with me. He was whining if he left the room. He didn't want to go down the hallway of my house by himself. He didn't want to go anywhere by himself. He didn't like sleeping in his crate. He wanted to sleep close to me. You know, obviously, like, that's not good for dogs. The breeder was very big on crate training and keeping the dog in its crate just to help with discipline and training and whatnot. So that's something that I kind of like wish that I knew about puppies specifically, because for the most part, kittens, I feel like, are like, they require a lot of attention, but to me, they don't require that much attention. After a couple weeks, they're a lot more independent. Cats in general are a lot more independent. Puppies and dogs are a lot more, you know, they want to be in your face. They want to be more engaged with you. But that was definitely like an adjustment for me, because I was used to watching kittens basically just be independent, or I would go do my own thing and kittens would still, you know, play and kind of be independent. Yuki, on the other hand, pretty much followed me everywhere, was always hot on my tail. I've almost accidentally stepped on him a couple times, and I feel so bad. But yeah, like, I was used to having cats that were like really independent. Definitely requires a lot of patience, especially if you're introverted like me, because even when it comes to animals, I'm like, after a while, I'm like, okay, you know, I've had enough. Like, I don't want you in my face too much. Like, go do something with yourself. Go play with your toys, do something. But no, Yuki was very clingy, very required just a lot of my attention. And that should have been a no-brainer for me, because I'm like, Kayla, like, you bought a puppy. Puppies require a lot of attention. But it was like, dang, I didn't realize it was gonna be that much attention. Yuki was hot on my tail everywhere I went. But one thing I do appreciate is I have a friend that loves my dog a lot. So like, whenever I needed a break or whatever, I could always just be like, hey, you know, take him for a little while, and he would just come scoop him. So Pomeranians can be really picky with their food. I don't know, if I'm being completely honest with you, I don't even know how my dog is still alive. This dog does not like to eat dog food. We have tried chicken and rice. We have tried different brands of dog food, taking our precautions, and obviously I would do my research and I would be careful, because you know, you can't swap a dog between dog foods too much. He wouldn't eat. It was concerning. How are you not, why don't you want to eat? You'll want to, you know, but as soon as somebody pulled their plate out, he wants their food. And then it was bad to the point where sometimes he was like throwing up stomach acid, and he was just nauseous and he was throwing up a lot. And sometimes he would eat his dog food. Like, we started buying him this like bougie fresh dog food. he would eat that for a little while, and then it was just right back to he wouldn't touch his food. Like $10, sometimes $20 on dog food, and he would not eat the dog food. So I was just really stressful in itself, because I was just like, yo, how is my dog still alive? My dog doesn't want to eat. My dog doesn't want to do anything. I can't keep giving him human food because I don't know how good that is for his stomach. And at one point, I was watching a lot of dog videos. A lot of people were giving their dogs like fresh food, and I just didn't feel comfortable with that. Yuki just has a sensitive stomach in general, so eventually a friend's mother did take him to the vet, and eventually he did get put on medicine. He is kind of doing a little bit better with eating, but not that much, and I'm still very concerned about him, but I'm just glad he's still here. If you have any suggestions about that, please comment down something below, because honestly at this point I don't really know what to do. All I can really just do is continue to take him to the vet regularly and maybe just discuss his eating habits. I don't know, because the breeder suggested chicken and rice. That kind of works. He'll eat salmon, not too much salmon. Eating his dog food is basically like a last resort, so I think that maybe he tries to go, oh my gosh, and yo, he always tries to eat cat food. Because my brother has a cat, her name is Eclipse. She's big, black, and fat, yeah. He's always going in my mother's room and trying to eat her cat food. And she was doing that constantly as a puppy too. And it was the point where sometimes he would go sneak and do it. That's why he would always have to be with somebody 24/7. He would end up puking that up too. So it was just like, I don't know, Leo. Like, y'all probably think I'm the worst dog owner ever, but I'm just like, I don't know what to do. I could do a lot more research and really just discuss it with his vet, which is what I am going to do. It's really like just concerning that his dog food is a last resort for him. Another thing that I wish I knew before I bought a dog is that dogs require a lot of patience to train. And Pomeranians are really smart and witty. I knew they were smart and witty, but Yuki's really smart. I remember as a puppy, I would discipline him and take things away from him and say, no, you can't have this. He would basically watch me to see where I would put something that I just took away from him, and then when I wasn't looking, he would go and try to take the thing back, whether it was taking it down from somewhere, whether it was going to pick it right back up, running with it. Like, I don't know if that's dogs in general, because again, I've always had cats, but that to me was like, yo, this dog is too smart for his own good. Like, why did you do that? Like, you know. And Yuki's really good with commands. Like, I can tell him to sit, you can tell him to give you paw, you can tell him to stay. But the only issue with telling him to stay though is that he'll only stay for like a good like minute, and then he'll, you know. But other than that, like, he's good with, you know, he's good with commands. He is good with commands, and I don't always have to have him on a leash unless, you know, he hasn't been outside in a long time, then he's like crazy. He goes crazy. He honestly just requires a lot of patience, and that's definitely something that I still have to work on with him, because sometimes I admit, like, I'll lose my temper and I'll get really frustrated with him. So Pomeranians, like, just a dog in general, they just require so much patience, and I'm just like, yo, just like a child requires a lot of patience. So I see where the Lord is working with me at. But I also feel like I wish I knew before I bought a dog was just how much grooming can be, like, every 2 weeks. Especially Yuki. When I first took Yuki, every single time I take Yuki to the groomers, he is scared of the groomers. Like, it takes about maybe 2 or 3 people to, you know, get him to be calm, stay still, so they can properly groom him. Yuki doesn't like his paws being touched. He just doesn't like being touched, like, at all, unless he wants to be touched. And my child's very much like that too. He just gets very fidgety and very panicky, and he's a very expressive dog, so, like, I just be feeling bad because he gets so much anxiety when I take him to the groomers. But it's like, it's gotta get done. I wish I would have really looked into the cost of grooming before buying a dog, because $60 or $50 every 2 weeks, girl, he be going there every, like, month or two, if I'm being completely honest with you, because, yo, that's expensive. Girl who did his, I don't know why I feel so nervous, but the girl who did his, who groomed him last time did a really bad job, like, really bad job. Like, it was almost like, don't look at him, like, got the ugly, like, ew. Wish I knew how much grooming cost, how often you really have to get your dog groomed. How a dog can act when they get groomed. The last thing that I really wish that I knew before I bought a dog was how important it is to have boundaries with your dog. And people are not gonna like this point, but I don't really care. I feel like people who have experiences, like, with their dog, you are with your dog 24/7, so I just feel like, as a dog owner, I wish I put my foot down more and was more assertive about certain boundaries for Yuki, especially since I was with him 24/7 and I was really learning his patterns and behaviors. Because So if you don't stick with the discipline, if you don't stick with the crate training, you know, when they're a puppy, you know, when they get older, they act wild. And Yuki's always been pretty wild. Like, he has his moments. He's calmed down a lot. But if you don't stick with the discipline and stick with the boundaries as a dog owner, especially when it comes to other people helping you, then you're gonna have a recipe for disaster. Like, you're gonna be able to get your dog as disciplined as you would want your dog to be. Because again, you're taking everybody's input and you're doing what everybody else feels like is best for your dog when you know what's best for your dog. It's also really important to make sure your dog is socialized, because Yuki acts so funny around people, especially little kids. It's bad. I remember when I first bought my daughter home, he was barking at her like crazy. I said, I should have socialized you more. I should have put more effort into putting him around other dogs. But then again, we were also in the middle of a pandemic. So I don't know. I got mixed feelings about that. But one thing I really did wish that I did do, like in the very beginning when I had him as a puppy, was just have more firm boundaries with him and what I wanted to do with him, and not care so much about what other people thought I was doing with my dog or said what I was doing with my dog, because I knew what the breeder told me, I knew what I was reading, what I was researching. And honestly, he shouldn't have been having walks he shouldn't have really been having walks as early as he was having walks. And I also should have been more careful with letting him walk on hot pavement. Or again, I would do it over so much better and so much differently. Oh, and another thing, yo, you cannot be lazy with a dog. That's all I gotta say, because Yuki needs to be walked like 3 times a day. And I promise you, I probably only, like, sometimes there are days where I have my days where sometimes I just take him outside and let him use the bathroom, because I be going through it and I have such a busy schedule. But that's why I'm thankful that I have a great support system and I have friends that love my dog a lot. But yeah, I mean, listen, I was warned about all of this, but at the same time, you know me. I've been wanting a dog since I was in 3rd grade. So I was like, yo, I don't care. I want my puppy. And I got my puppy. He keeps me company. He still sleeps with me at night, and I'm really happy. And I'll never regret my decision, because Yuki's so adorable and I love him so much. If you think about getting a Pomeranian, I still think that you should, but just know that they can be they're very sensitive dogs. They're very smart dogs, and they require a lot of care and attention. So just make sure that you're mentally and emotionally ready and prepared for that, because sometimes, again, when I was going through I was experiencing like depression or anything like that, or sadness, I generally could not take care of my dog, and I would let my friend take my dog for a couple weeks, because they require a lot of attention. They do. And if you're thinking about getting a Pomeranian, you still should, because they are the best dogs ever and they're so cute. Somebody's at the door. I know. And they're very alert. Look at him. He's barking. Stop. Those are some of the things that I wish I knew before I'm looking at the wrong screen. Those are some of the things that I wish I knew before I bought a dog. So if you guys have any tips, any tricks, any advice that you want to give me, or any pointers, comments, whatever, please make sure you comment down below. Love you. I hope you liked this video today, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Thank you.